Good morning, Mr. Howell.
Are you Mrs. Tisdale?
I'm doing very well, Dr. Howell. Thank you.
I know here close to my home county, but I know it was right down the hill from Boone, some top of here.
Okay, so you lived in Boone, is that where you grew up?
I grew up. Finished school there, finished the college at UNC at Chapel Hill.
Okay.
And I finished Emory here, Boston School here. I met my future wife. The last thing my mother told me, said, now don't go down there and marry one of Georgia Peaches. She laid up and said, remember, the state of North Carolina is giving you education from first grade through college. And it was fair that she come back to her home state. Needless to say, she, you know, 35, 40 years after I married, she still wasn't too happy about it.
That's an empowerment.
Hey there, Mr. Clark. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
I made a couple of copies of the end.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Mr. Smith.
How are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you, sir.
Lovely to see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Howell?
Wow. Good to see you.
Sure, glad to have you back.
Well, it's good to be back.
It is.
Good.
Social Service Board, and I come to order for a three-month monthly meeting. Today's Thursday, May the 10th, 2012, 10 a.m. We're meeting in the conference room of the Public Safety Complex, 3520 Benton Down Road, Cummings, Georgia. Present for the meeting, Mr. Lancer, member, Avery Howell, chairman, Mr. Smith, vice chairman, Mr. Miles, our hearing officer. Ms. Clark, safety. Ms. Lorenzo?
Yes.
Okay.
News button. You got it. We're glad to have you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Good to see you, Mr. President. And Ms. Tisdale?
Yes, sir, thank you.
Glad to have you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Smith.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Gentlemen, if you look at the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that the agenda be approved.
I second that.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Unanimous. Thank you, sir. From the Minnesota, April meeting was April the 12th.
Make a motion the minutes be approved.
I second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Ms. Clerk, please.
Yes, I corrected that. The official minutes reflect that change you sent to me.
Back in one.
Yeah, no, just one.
Thank you very much. Under old business. Mr. Chairman, I'm sure something.
Mr. Chairman and members, there is no update from the court system on either the John Gooch writ of cert or the Jeff Chance writ of cert on remand. Again, as the board has instructed me, I will appear in court if and when we ever receive notice of hearing on either one and report to the board immediately thereafter. Nothing has happened in the last 30 days on either matter.
We hope this time makes your things be difficult. We should have another judge focus.
I understand as of January of next year, that'll happen. That'll be a good thing.
Well, one thing that they admitted, that Forsyth County, Captain Grace needs another Superior Court judge. And Grace by another judge. Hopefully, if you're not judge, this sort of thing will have to drag along these sort of cases. But the judge have to, I guess, have to take serious cases, like criminal cases. Anything else on old business?
No, sir.
Clerk, do you have anything?
Yes.
All right, any new business?
Mr. Chairman, at the last meeting, you weren't here. We had Mrs. Giles from Mr. Miles' office, and she gave us a brief summary of the open record, open meeting discussion. Mm-hmm. We pretty well covered that. As acting chairman, I even allowed members of the public that were here to ask the questions of Mrs. Giles. We wanted to get everything out on the table. Now, it was very informative, Mr. Miles. She did an excellent job. I think the reason that this item is on the agenda is because our clerk has attended some meetings in the recent past put on by the county attorney, and this is more for her to update the board on what she learned, if anything.
Yes, the county attorney, actually we sent out a lot of the changes once the governor had signed the legislation. We were sent, you know, a packet for immediate attention that was sent to all department heads, especially those that serve in or employees that serve as a clerk to boards. And we were also mandated to attend two trainings that was held at the county administration building and was conducted by Ken Gerard, the county attorney. One was on changes to the open records portion, and the other for the Open Meetings Act. There was, certainly I had highlighted, you know, that some of the different changes or areas that, you know, I felt would be important to me as your clerk on the postings, but given the, I guess, review last month by Ms. Giles, there's not anything additional or conflicting that I really saw. One matter that may be a bit different was just kind of the executive session. I mean, for me, and it would just be that the minutes of executive session shall be recorded, but it's not open to the public, and that the minutes must specify each issue discussed, and that the substance that was discussed. Litigation is the only thing to be recorded in the minutes, is the fact that, you know, if there's attorney-client discussion, you just have to know that it's attorney-client discussion and the subject should be identified. And then the other recommendation from the county attorney was that any votes that are in executive session should be recorded the same as regular session votes.
Basically, I think it's pretty much those countries want out.
I think for the most part, we have an executive session, we've kept an executive session agenda, and typically your executive sessions are very focused, not like many other board meetings, but they're not open to the public, but we'll just make sure that, you know, we have that record of those minutes and the subject matter.
See, typically your executive sessions typically are just deliberation over the facts of a case. It's sort of like a jury deliberating over the facts of a case. It's not like other public bodies where, you know, you're making decisions on real estate acquisitions or how to settle a case or not settle a case. So you're a little different in that respect. So I think, you know, we consistently have, when you've gone into executive session, it's been for the purpose of deliberating the outcome of a case, and then you come out once that deliberation is over and make your vote and your decision public, which is what you've been doing, which is consistent with what
you're doing. Could I ask a question in regards to that?
Sure.
Ms. Clark said that we were supposed to record the minutes in our executive session. Does that mean that we have to record our deliberations?
No, sir. What the law intends is that you would, and as she said, minutes of executive session are not made public. There is a provision under the law for the challenge where a judge can review them in camera, which means that the judge is back in his office reviewing them privately to make sure that they comply with the law. You would need to record what you were doing. And and let's say we were hearing the case of, you know, John Q. Doe that was on an appeal. Your minutes would reflect that you conducted deliberations related to the appeal of John Q. Doe, and that after those deliberations, a vote was held to either uphold the action of discipline or to reverse the action of discipline or to modify that. And of course, as we currently do, I think the law just sort of brings into focus what we were doing anyway, which is you come back into regular session once the decision is reduced to writing and formally vote in open session and announce your decision in open session with, of course, a courtesy copy to the party.
So none of the discussions within that framework, you just announce what your purpose is, what the results are, no minutes are taken in the deliberation.
Other than to reflect that you were doing that.
Yeah, we were doing it. Yes.
And the reason for that is very simple. I mean, it'd be the same thing as if a jury kept minutes of what they were doing. All you would have is collateral attack after collateral attack by either side, whoever lost, based on what some minute from a juror said. So that's how I interpret it, and I think that's consistent with Mr. Gerard's interpretation of what we should do. But we will have minutes that do reflect that in order to comply with the law. Yes, sir.
Mr. Strike, we don't have meetings, so you think we're probably in compliance with what you stay there?
Absolutely. I think we're definitely in compliance, and I think we go above and beyond even before this, was law. You know, we've always tried to, you know, put the public notices and agendas on the website. Well, now that's mandatory. We also post the meetings here at the meeting location, but we also post it downtown at administration. So I think we definitely, meet the requirements, and we go above and beyond. And we also, you know, provide the written or oral notice to the legal organ. Well, we do that for special meetings, which is required, but we also do that for regular meetings, which is not necessarily required. I believe that, no changes really in the way we would do business. Another thing that changed for some clerks in writing the minutes is that a description of each motion or proposal should be identified, but the identity of the persons making and seconding the motion should be written. Well, we do that already in our minutes. I always identify who makes the motion, who seconds the motion, and, you know, those in favor. And I also identify, you know, if someone's absent, just as was in last month's minutes, even though I always notice you know, make a note that you are absent from that vote.
I'm thinking about something we did. We signed a minute. Actually, we signed a copy of it.
There you go. Just waiting for you. No, oh, that's okay. I will get you.
She wasn't going to let you get away, no problem.
Probably not. One thing else I noticed there, about the charge for the fees going.
It is on the open records. Yes, if there are charges, if someone requests records of the board, for instance, if there was something, a lot of our records I keep electronically, yeah. So I can just send that to people electronically, but if they wanted to print, then yes, the charge would be 10 cents instead of 25.
Another thing too, in case of violation, penalty, could it be as much as $500?
$1,000.
That makes it $2,500. My question is this, who pays it?
Yeah, a good question.
Sorry, Joe.
Come in, it's not late. Well, they just said this is going to happen. This is going to be like the charge. They just said, who and what? But I assume it was. If I wish I could cut that real well, and I was real pleased. Got this house bill and signed it before I had to put it in the box.
Yes, sir, I agree.
Except for charging 2 months to the bill. Hey, 25 cents.
Right, and we, yes, we would make that change.
Let the record state that Mr. David Nile came in to be with us.
Glad to be here.
Thank you very much, Mr. Clark. I'm glad you attended that meeting and all the information about that. Anything about new appeals that you know of?
No, no, I have. Appeals have been received, Mr. Chairman.
Peace of mind. They recorded it, please.
Hasn't been for a while, which is good.
Knock on wood, there's been peace before and all the same. I will lose us. We don't need to go into executive session.
No, sir.
No.
Anything else need to bring up for the chair?
I make a motion we adjourn.
I second that.
All in favor of adjourn, say aye.
Aye.
Stand adjourned. And the next meeting will be June 14th.
Correct. Yes.
It's going to be 91 next month.
Okay, bye-bye.
Did you work on that?
I
lived here Thursday.
Oh. Was she going to do it?
No, not really on salary, so.
I've been down at the court. I'm ready to back it back.
It's $1,000 for the first violation, up to $2,500 for the second violation.
Okay, let's get to work.
We're within a 12-month period, but who pays it? Is it the county's pocket? pocket. Is it your pocket? That's a very good question. You didn't get an answer. And I think you deserve an answer. You've got a lawyer sitting there who says that's a very good question and doesn't give you the information.
Right.
I'd like to know that.
Yeah, we'll have to find it.
Who do you ask if you can't ask your counsel?
We'll have to get a clarification.
He should have said, I don't know the answer, and I'll get back with you with that information. Just, you know, that's a good question. But what is the answer? Yes, we all agree, it's a wonderful question. Tell us the answer, because we need the information, and you're not giving it to us.
Well, you know, if it's in church, you take up a special offering. In this case, I...
How's all your clan doing, Doc?
Pretty good, thank you.
I've seen better days. We all got to go leave here sometime, don't we? Ain't going to stay forever.
I heard something. Some sign in.
Good seeing you. Appreciate you.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Very much, Mr. Harden. Thank you very much for your...
Love my dog.
This is the thing, it gets for a Tennessee, you put all these knickknacks, you want me to buy them.
Right.
One guy caught my eye. He said, why worry? If you're sick, you either going to get well or you're going to die.
Yeah.
If you get well, you got nothing to worry about.
That's right, that's right. And I know where I'm going. I done made my plans, I know where I'm going.
Well, if you're from heaven, you've got nothing to worry about.
I ain't going to try to blow it in the head of nobody to get their ticket away from them, you understand, but I'm ready to go. I've had a good life. I said, look, if I'm laying in a box and you see somebody squalling over me, go up and say, look, you need to shut up. That guy had four phones with me, three people I ever met in my life, and it's true. I've had a good, full
life. Live to love and love to live.
Absolutely.
But anyway, the second part of this thing, to go to heaven, if you go to the other place, you're probably so busy greeting old friends, you don't have time to worry. What a clincher.
What's that?